Seasons at Agnes Scott College are simply breathtaking. The way the sun pokes through the main bell tower, the way the ginkgo trees spread golden shadows on the sidewalk in autumn, when the snap of winter touches our campus and leaves every blade of grass frostbitten and powder white, when all of this is exchanged for the flowers that sprout just a bit early for Scotties, eager to bloom with them in the springtime. Something I notice every year is how different the flowers are that appear, still beautiful, but bringing their own color, shape, and cheer to our campus. When I entered Agnes the first year, I met so many Scotties new and prepared to shift with the seasons. As the years have progressed, we have found ways to work through our wintry times together, to be the first to plant new ideas into our communities, to breathe laughter into the air in times of joy, and to stand with our Scotty siblings in times where we were expected to pick up the shards of a seemingly broken world and rearrange them in the shape of justice. When I think of Agnes Scott and what has made it the beautiful microcosm of the world it is today, I think of our leaders. Like the ever-changing flowers, each of them bloomed where they were planted, bringing something fresh to campus, coming from far and wide to reshape what we look like, knowing that when the seasons change, they will have made their mark. When I entered Agnes Scott, I didn't know that I would witness a season change such as this. President Emerita Elizabeth Quiche spent 12 years here watering seeds of change. When it was time for her to establish roots elsewhere, I wondered who would grow leaders like she did. President Lezak came to us a rosebud asked to blossom at the rate of Agnes Scott, which is not easy. At every turn, she has worked to rise to the occasion. I recall having dinner in her home, where she hosted Scotties from vastly different backgrounds, working from day one to understand the kind of support our community needs. From finding ways to make Scotties feel safe and supported in their homes, to responding to crises, taking a beat in her hectic days to reach out and listen to students, echoing our concerns on the highest level, and finally embracing Summit and continuing to build on this dream turned fabric of Agnes Scott's identity. In her 329 days here, she has enjoyed her first alumni luncheons, Black Cat, Hub Sing, Sophomore Ring Ceremony, Alumni Weekend, and Spark. She has had time to work on her favorite spot in the porch, thinking of new ways to bring her own shade of Agnes Purple to her work. She has truly bloomed where she was planted. What making her presidency official means for our campus means that we are entering a season where the sun shines on Agnes and where we sow those seeds of change in every dilapidated patch of earth and on every summit. She has pledged to support Scotties in leading everywhere we find ourselves. I am confident that whether we enter good or trying times, together, with shovels in hand, we will unearth new ways to think deeply, live honorably, and engage the intellectual and social challenges of our times together. Thank you. Thank you.